This is Sense. It's a clever little box that'll give you unprecedented insight into your home's entire power usage. I've been using it for a couple of months and I like it, but the pace at which it learns is a little bit frustrating. Now, you install Sense in your breaker box. A couple of wires run out to breakers to power the Sense unit itself, and then these clamps are put around the two hot wires coming out of your meter. They electromagnetically listen to the power flowing into your house, and that's the basis for all the magic that this does. I installed it myself, and you probably can too. Remember to turn the power off before wiring it up, and if you're not confident, please get an electrician to do it for you. It runs over Wi-Fi, and there's also an extension cable to mount the antenna on the outside of the breaker box if needed. It's a nice touch, although I found that it worked for me fine mounted inside. Data starts flowing as soon as it's up and running, and at its most basic level, Sense will tell you the entire amount of power being consumed by your house. It's a watt reading, and immediately you can watch it rise and fall as different appliances are switched on and off. I quickly discovered that one set of lights I had used 180 watts, quite the contrast to the LED bulbs elsewhere in my house. Now, it's a fun game, and you start to learn a little bit about how much power you're using, but the real magic takes a few weeks to begin. As Sense starts to observe your house, it starts to look for the fingerprints of certain electrical appliances, and in a couple of weeks, you'll start to see it identify certain things and provide an extra level of information about them. For example, when they're switched on and off, and how much power they're using over the last week or the last month. This is really interesting data, and you can do other things too, such as set alerts. I have one for if my refrigerator is off for more than an hour, for example. But as good as it is, it takes a long time for Sense to discover these things, and that's my biggest complaint about it. And unfortunately, there doesn't seem to be a way to speed any of this up. When I was at CES, I met with Sense, and I told them this, and they said they completely understand and explained it's slow because it's actually pretty difficult to do. Now, to me, it's obvious that, say, my microwave is on because I pressed the button and I saw the power rise on Sense. But the Sense unit itself just sees a change in electricity consumption in my house. It doesn't know that something was just switched on or off, and it doesn't know what it was. It uses machine learning to try and spot patterns and figure it out, and that's why it takes a while. Mike Phillips, Sense's CEO, told me it's a bit like listening to a room full of people talking and trying to figure out what each one is saying. At first, it's all just noise. Now, some appliances have telltale fingerprints, the equivalent of, say, a distinctive accent in that room of people, and that makes them easier to spot, but most aren't so easy to distinguish. In the 2 months that I've been using Sense, it's identified 9 appliances. It's included my refrigerator, a hot water boiler, a rice cooker, those power-hungry bathroom lights that I have, and my furnace and oven. Now, they're all pretty large power consumers, but something like a Google Home speaker, or say the microwave that I don't use very much, that's going to be more difficult for it to figure out. Everything that it hasn't identified is still recorded, but in one of two buckets. Always on, which is the constant draw of power consumed by your home, no matter the time of day or night, and everything else. Now, this always on consumption is pretty interesting. In my house, it's about 300 watts. That costs me about $30 per month in electricity, so I've been trying to reduce it to save money. Now, if there is a particular appliance you want to monitor, there is a shortcut. You'll need to buy a TP-Link Casa or Wemo smart plug with energy monitoring. You plug the device in via the smart plug, and the smart plug talks to Sense and sends over the power data. I've got it in my living room on all my entertainment gadgets. This is what it looks like when I switch the TV on. It'll track this collective usage and give me an estimate of how much power this bunch of electronics uses every month. Sense works with Google Assistant and Amazon Alexa. You can ask things like if the water heater is on or how much energy you're consuming. If you have solar, you can ask how much energy you're generating. And so that's Sense. Despite the frustrating pace of automated discovery, I found it quite useful. With a bit of manual detective work, you should be able to figure out what a bunch of appliances in your house are using and track down where you're wasting energy. And that means that the $299 investment in Sense has the ability to pay for itself if you put in the work. There are no monthly running charges for this either. But perhaps the most exciting thing about Sense is what it could become. More users will mean more data and better detection of devices. And with that could come much more advanced notifications, such as noticing changes in patterns of power usage that might tell you if a fault is developing in something in your house. TechHive rated Sense 4 out of 5.